You just standing here wasting everything that you know.
That's true, though.
You know, children are so smart.
Yeah.
A young boy enters a barber shop, and the barber whispers to the customer, "This is the dumbest kid in the world. Watch while I prove it to you." The barber puts a dollar bill in one hand and two quarters in the other. Then calls the boy over and asks him, "Which do you want, son?" The boy takes the quarters and not the dollar. "What did I tell you?" said the barber. "That kid is the dumbest kid in the world." Later, when the customer leaves the barbershop, he sees a young boy coming out of the ice cream store. "Hey, son, may I ask you a question? Why did you take the quarters instead of the dollar?" The little boy licks his cone and replies, "Because the day I take the dollar, the game's over." Children are smart, aren't they? People are keep that money coming. As you are receiving email, it is wise to remember how easily this wonderful technology can be misused, sometimes unintentionally, and with serious consequences. Consider the case of the Michigan man who left the snow-filled streets of Detroit for a vacation in Florida. His wife was on a business trip and was planning to meet him there the next day. When he reached his hotel, he decided to send his wife a quick email. Unable to find the scrap of paper on which he had written her email address, he did the best to type it from memory. Unfortunately, he missed one letter, and his note was directed instead to an elderly preacher's wife whose husband had passed away the day before. When the grieving widow checked her email, she took one look at the monitor, let out a piercing scream, and fell to the floor in a dead faint. Hearing the scream, her family rushed into the room and saw this note on the screen. "Dearest wife, just got checked in. Everything prepared for your arrival tomorrow. P.S. Sure is hot down here." That's good. Praise be to God. You know, we're a blessed people, and we need to recognize that every single day. I like what Minister Knight said when I asked him, I'll say to him how he's doing. He looks at me very somberly and say, "I'm a blessed man." We are. We're blessed. If God said it, we can say it. Amen. I was in the store yesterday, and there's a little boy in there, and he was in a stroller. And I thought he was a little big for the stroller, because he looked to be like 7 or 8 years old. And he had some Mickey Mouse ears. And I said to him, "You look so cute. And with the little ears on, you know." So I knew something was kind of wrong with him. And what appeared to be his grandmother said, "Well, actually, those ears are from Make-A-Wish Foundation. And he's on his way to Disney World." And I was just so overwhelmed with grief for a second there, because I know what the Make-A-Wish Foundation is all about. And this kid had to be like 7 or 8 years old, maybe. You know, we just blessed, you know, when I look at that child and you want to just go up and lay hands on him and pray for him, you know, but I didn't do it, but I wanted to do it, but I didn't do it, but I did pray for him. But, you know, it's just a sad thing how the enemy, you know, can just come in and just wreak havoc on people. So we just got to pray much for our children. Amen?
Amen.
Sue Ellison, I don't know how many of you know Sue. She used to sit in the back with me. Anyhow, she had colon surgery, and she's receiving a healing. She's in Sarasota Memorial Hospital. She'll be home tomorrow. She's doing just fine.
Amen.
Amen. We have Miss Linda, Sister Linda Hart, visiting with us. She said she found us on the web, that she was led by the Spirit to come here this morning. You're in the right place. Amen. Glory be to God. Also, want to mention that the thrift store has chapel every day at 11:30. You can go up there and be ministered to every single day. So take advantage of that. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, Bible study here, of course, 7:30 p.m. on Tuesday, praise practice. 7 p.m. on Wednesday, we have prayer on Thursday. Also, we have Bonnie and Andrew that have stepped up to do the communion for us, and they're going to do it the last Sunday, fourth Sunday, and every month. So thank you so much.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Sister Linda, you're welcome to come anytime.
Yes.
We love you. We love having visitors to come in. Dr. Don and Paula, y'all ain't visitors. Y'all are just family. We love y'all so much. And every time you come, you're just a blessing to us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Flo, don't forget about tonight.
Okay.
And Saturday.
Oh, yeah.
The Saturday?
Yeah, the thrift store having their celebration.
Oh, Michael, why don't you come and share with us a minute about that? Send it, Wendy.
Oh, the leadership meeting?
No,
about your sitting at the thrift store in Saturday.
Oh, thank you. You play the drum.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah.